I was leaving my apartment complex and heading through the parking lot the other day when I noticed someone standing near my car. "Are you Brian Alexander Bosworth?" he asked. "Well, I go by Alex these days, but hold on, you're not with the police, are you?" "No," he said. "FBI? No. DEA? FYI? OTK? KNYO? Daughters of the American Revolution? Mugwumps? Seventh-day Adventist? Loyal Order of Lower Mammals? Northern California Division? No, I'm not with any organization," he told me. "Look, the thing is, I'm your son." "Oh, so you're not with BOC. Who's that?" "Blue Oyster Cult." "What would they want with you?" "They want me to stop fearing the Reaper. Also more cowbell." "Right," the man said with a dismissive shrug. "So do you remember meeting a girl at a Men Without Hats concert back in 1989? "Ooh, 89. That's a tricky time for me. I was experimenting with drugs back then. It's an ongoing experiment, actually. I got a government grant during the Clinton administration." "That's great," he interrupted. "The reason I ask is because, according to my mother, the two of you went back to her place after the concert. You had a few drinks, smoked some weed, and, well, you know." "Ah," I said. "We put on elaborate latex outfits and played Queen Beatrix and her very naughty dog?" "No." "Oh, well, then it probably wasn't me." "Yeah, it was you. You had a one-night stand with my mother, and 9 months later I was born." "Okay, but why didn't she ever contact me and let me know I had a son?" "It's complicated. She was technically still married to her first husband when she got pregnant. It was an ugly divorce, and by the time it was finally over, she never wanted to get married again. So when I came along, she decided to raise me alone and not drag anyone else into it. She never blamed you. I guess you just didn't seem responsible enough to father a child." "I'm not saying that to hurt your feelings." "That's okay," I told him. "I'm just responsible enough to know how irresponsible I am." "Wait a minute. She was still married when I slept with her? That means I committed adultery. I broke the seventh commandment." "Wait a second. 7, 8, 9. Yes, that means all I have to do is kill somebody, and I'll have done all 10. And you know what's nice? I already have a victim picked out." "Your days are numbered, Wilt Chamberlain." "Wilt Chamberlain is already dead," he told me. "Damn it, really? Well, in that case, your days are numbered. Carol Burnett?" "What do you have against Carol Burnett?" "Nothing. She's just my backup in case anything happened to Wilt Chamberlain. By the way, what did happen to Wilt? Did he get decapitated by a ceiling fan?" "I don't think so." "Because that would have been a really cool way to go." "Yeah, Mom said you were kind of quirky." "Quirky?" I said. "That was 30 years ago. These days I'm completely batshit insane." "I see," he said, laughing a little. "You're just joking, though, right?" "Of course." "So Carol Burnett is safe?" "Sure. For now." "So why did you track me down? Is there something you want? Something you need to know?" "Actually, my mother wanted me to bring up a certain financial matter." "Oh, man, here we go," I said. "The moment you said you were my son, I knew this had to be about money." "Yeah, see, that morning when you left her apartment, you borrowed $15 for a cab, and she was wondering if you could get that back to her." "It's always the money," I said, reaching for my back pocket. "Hey, she just wanted me to ask. I mean, if you don't want to pay it back." "No, no, I don't want anyone saying I don't take care of my obligations." I took out my wallet and opened it. "Dang, all I have is a 20. I'll tell you what, why don't you just keep the whole thing?" "I can't let you do that," he said. "Please," I said, placing the bill in his hand. "No, I wasn't there to provide food, shelter, clothing, or any much-needed care and emotional support, so just keep the change and we'll call it even." He nodded and put the money in his pocket. "So you figure your parenting skills are worth about $5. Probably closer to 350, but what the heck? Go buy yourself something nice. It's your birthday." "It's not my birthday." "Hey, you're my son and I love you. Can we not fight for 5 seconds? "You're right. Thanks, Dad." He reached out to put his arms around me. "Whoa!" I shouted as I shoved him away. "I don't hug people I just met. Take that lovey-dovey shit someplace else, Junior." And so my long-lost son turned and walked back out of my life. As I was driving to work, I began getting nostalgic about my youth. The 80s, what a great time. The air was filled with new wave music and cocaine. The Reagan administration was making America proud of itself again while covertly trading deadly weapons to Iran. Michael Jackson had just started carving up his face, and we all had a good laugh as Andrew Dice Clay dehumanized women through the subtle art of filthy fourth-grade-level nursery rhymes. It was a golden decade, Just as I started feeling all warm and fuzzy, I realized something. I didn't go to a Men Without Hats concert in 1989. In fact, that band broke up in 87. And I didn't smoke weed back then. I snorted PCP. And now that I thought about it, that man claiming to be my son was clearly older than I am. He had to be at least 70. Hell, he was using a walker. The whole thing was a scam. So let this be a lesson to all you kids out there. Don't make the mistakes I made. Avoid the use of drugs and alcohol, especially in conjunction with torrid, hot, steamy, unprotected sex with one or possibly four underage sexual partners of various genders as God intended, because in the long run, it could cost you more than you can possibly imagine. Upwards to $20. Hi, I'm Angela Lansbury, bringing you this important message on behalf of the United Way and the New Mexico Department of Motor Vehicles. Good night.